So I think in some senses you can, you know, if you think about as an investor from outside, you can come into a country and say that I want to set up a plant in the country. And for me to set up a plant in the country, I need to bring in money. And using that money, we will buy whatever capital equipment is required, etc., etc. We will pay for workers' wages, you know, we'll set up a company, etc. Now, once you make that investment and you're a, you know, you're an equity holder in that kind of a plant, it's not very easy for you to exit it, right? It's not something that you tomorrow decide that, you know, I can sell this and get out. Which is why the foreign direct investment of this nature is usually considered to be sticky and longer term.
Right.
Because if you're doing that in a country, you better be sure that, you know, you are okay to be there for 5, 7, 10 years time. On the other hand, if there is a market for equities, which is what the stock market is, you can decide to buy a company's shares, exactly the same thing in a slightly different way. And tomorrow, if you don't like, you can just sell the shares back
right. And
take your money out, right? Which is why the investment in the equity markets, even though effective is the same, you're buying into a company, is considered to be something which people can get in and get out very fast. And hence, it is considered to be in some senses hot money, that if tomorrow the market conditions change, people can take their money out. FDI, on the other hand, is much more longer term.